Here are the four functions, if you would, of management. First of all, you have the planning. The planning stage is basically you are choosing appropriate organizational goals and courses of action to best achieve those goals. Now, that simply means that you're going to be coming together, talking about the overall plan. It could be short-term planning, it could be long-term planning, but you're going to sit down and find out what the company needs to do and what direction it needs to head in. That's the essence of the planning stage. You have to sit down and map it all out. Then the organizational skills come into play, the organizing. Establish task and authority relationships that allow people to work together to achieve organization and goals. This is the part that's a little bit give and take, because you're going to want to organize. You're going to have very different personalities in the room. But what's going to happen eventually is you're going to come hopefully to the same accord, the same concept, because you're initially going to be looking at the mission statement of the company. You've already done the planning stage. And now you're going to actually think about organizing your thought, which direction to head in now. Now, you always need the next phase, which is called leading. You have to have someone that's going to motivate you, coordinate, and energize individuals and groups to work together to achieve organizational goals. I like that particular area because of the fact that it goes back to communication skills. Effective communication and open communication allows for this next process to take place very smoothly if you do have the open communication skills. And that's part of the leading. You have to coordinate, motivate, and inspire your employees. Then you get to one area that's a little touchy-feely. It's called the controlling stage. Now, that sounds like a word that you probably wouldn't want to use in business, controlling, but it actually is the essence of what's going to happen in terms of establishing accurate measurement, a measurement tool, and monitoring systems to evaluate how well the organization has achieved its goals. So there is the part that a lot of companies do on a regular basis. They do the controlling. At the community college level, we call it student learning outcomes, which means at the end of the course, say business communication or business English, we stop for a minute. We assess what we've done and determine whether or not the students will be successful and whether they have achieved what we said they would achieve from the beginning. Here's the same thing for companies. They want to have an accurate measurement of what they've done. And that's the four functions of management. Here's some steps in the planning process. Let's think about this for a minute. Everything we do takes time and has to be accurate, especially in business. So you have to have the planning process, the steps to it. First of all, you want to deciding on which goal the organization will pursue. Now, we aren't speaking of the mission statement. We're speaking of individual goals that allow and support the mission statement of most companies. So, for example, let's say we're going green now. So environmentally, your first goal is to make sure that your company, hopefully, is at a satisfactory level of being green. That's when you, first of all, decide what the goals you're going to be if you're going to go green, I should say. Deciding what course of action to adopt at this point to attain those goals, which means you're going to have top-down leadership, maybe bottom-up leadership, or lineal leadership, which means across the board. Deciding what courses of action to adopt to attain those goals. What happens is a lot of people, they start out in business and they assume whatever they've done over the years will be effective. And they don't adopt to the changes. We're speaking of technology. We're speaking of cultural differences. We're speaking of maybe even locality. All those things have to be taken into consideration. So deciding what course of action to adopt to attain those goals is part of the planning process, one of the steps. Step three is deciding how to allocate organizational resources. Here comes the money. Here comes the people. Here comes the manpower. This is when you decide how much you need to put into particular goals in terms of the resources, the manpower, as well as, let's say, transferring in people from other companies. So this is when you actually sit down and you allocate what's going to allow you to achieve those goals. Very, very tangible resources as well.